In this video, we will talk about the color perception. Have you ever stopped to think about how we perceive colors? I agree with anyone who thinks it's complex. But let's simplify things. The colors we observe are the result of stimuli caused by electromagnetic radiation in the photoreceptor cells of our eyes. Photoreceptor cells convert light into biological stimuli that provide our vision. However, the color perception changes from one species to another. Scientific studies indicate that marine mammals have poor eyesight. They may be monochromatics, that is, they have only one type of photoreceptor. Among these animals are dolphins, whales, seals, and walrus. Animals like honeybee and human have three types of photoreceptor. Among the few animals whose vision has been scientifically studied, it can be said that the goldfish, zebrafish, and zebrafinch are tetrachromatics. That is, they have four types of photoreceptor cells. Therefore, these animals are able to see a wider range of the electromagnetic spectrum than humans. The mantis shrimp has the most powerful vision of the animal kingdom. It has between 12 and 16 types of photoreceptor cells. Since we can't see as well as this animal, let's talk about our color perception. Under normal conditions, the human being sees only a small part of the electromagnetic spectrum, the so-called visible spectrum. The visible spectrum extends from 400 nanometers to about 700 nanometers. The visible spectrum can be well represented by the rainbow. We can see those colors because we have three types of photoreceptor cells. In general, what you can see depends on the interaction of the electromagnetic energy with surface. What you see is the result of the electromagnetic waves scattered, transmitted, or reflected from a surface. As an example, when we see the chemical compound luminol in the glow of a firefly in the dark, we are seeing the light that is transmitted and not reflected. In this example, the red light is being reflected by the flower petal, while the other colors are being absorbed. Orange is the resulting color reflected. Yellow is the color reflected. The black color absorbs all color in the spectrum. The white color reflects all white light. When an object is illuminated with monochromatic light of a color different from its color, that object appears black to our eyes. The color of an object does not change if the monochromatic light is of the same color. The green color of the leaves is due to the presence of pigments called chlorophyll. There are two pigments, chlorophyll A and B. There are other types of chlorophyll, namely chlorophyll C, D, and F. Chlorophyll of type C occur in various algae, while of type D and F on cyanobacteria. The difference between those structures from the structure of chlorophyll A is indicated in magenta color. Another type of pigment known as carotenoids is responsible for the yellow, orange, and red coloring of fruits and vegetables. Carotenoids are divided into two large groups, xanthophyll and carotene. Anthocyanins are important pigments. These pigments are responsible for the pigmentation of many fruits and flowers, such as strawberries, grapes, and blackberries. The phthalates are also a good example of biological pigments. The most known example is the betaine. You also have pigments in our bodies. Melanin is responsible for the coloring of our skin, hair, and eyes. Hemoglobin is a pigment that gives our blood a reddish color. Knowing the power of colors, the food industry has increasingly used more dyes in its products. It is also possible to use natural dyes and pigments to color food and materials. In general, there are many pigments and dyes applied to the coloring of clothes, cosmetics, food, and so on. Subscribe to the channel, activate the bell to receive notifications, and follow us on social media. See you in the next video.